I'd like to show you how to integrate PI DataLink for Excel services with RT WebParts. In this lab, we are going to make use of the new Excel Web Access WebPart to demonstrate the integration of the PI server with SharePoint using RT WebParts. Most of this lab will show you how to publish the Excel spreadsheet to SharePoint and how to configure the Excel Web Access web part. If you would like to see the final result and don't want to work through the lab, all you have to do is open Internet Explorer. There is a solution site in which we have created already a solution with the web part and the spreadsheet. In here you can see the end result. You can search through tag names and different ranges. But let's go ahead and start working on this lab. The first thing that we want to do is go to the Labs folder, Client Tools, Workspace folder, where we already have a spreadsheet named DataLink Demo. Open that file, and once you open it, you will see that it doesn't have the correct PI server name in there. You will have to update the PI server name to OSIsoft-TRNG. Once we do that, we are also going to create two parameters that will help us when we publish this file to SharePoint. So PI server, let's update that OSIsoft-TRNG, and we can see in here the values that are being displayed. In order to get the graph, the easiest way to do that is to save your file without doing any other changes and close it, and then reopen the file and allow Excel to update the graph. And that is the easiest way in which I've been able to do that. Now what we want to do is create two parameters, one for the tag name and one for the time range. The way we do that is by selecting the cell B2 where we have the tag name. We go to the Formulas tab, go to the Define Name, and in the Define Names menu there is a dialog that appears. We want to enter tag name as the name of this parameter, click OK, and we can do the same for the time range. Go to cell B6, go to define name, and we will name this time range. And now if you look at the name manager, you should see the two new parameters, tag name and time range. Okay, we are now ready to save and publish this file. And what we want to do is to use the publishing feature to Excel services. Make sure that you uncheck the Open in Excel Services checkbox and click on Excel Services option. Make sure that you only have sheet number 1 selected, and in the parameters click Add and select the two parameters that we created so that they are also published along with the file. Now we want to go ahead and save or publish this file to a SharePoint library. The easiest way to get the path right to the library is to open SharePoint and navigate to the library where you want to save that file. Under Lab Site we have a Shared Documents library. If you click on it, you will be able to go ahead and copy the path to that library. Now I'm going to go ahead and let me show you right here. One thing that we don't need is the forms and all items portion of the library. So just copy the path to the name of the library, Shared Documents. Go back to Excel. Let's go ahead and paste that right in front of the file and click Save and see if we can perform the operation. So now we should be able to go back to the library, refresh, and there we have our new file that was published to the library. In here, we can go ahead now and create a web part page by going to Site Actions, Create, selecting Web Part Page, and I'm going to name this DataLink Web Access, and I'm going to select a layout that has a header, left column, and body, and I want to save that to my shared documents library and click Create. Now that I have my new web part page, I can go ahead and add web parts. In the body portion of the page, I'm going to click Add a web part, and I'm going to find the Excel web access web part, select that one, add, and then I'm going to configure this to show the file that I published to the shared documents by clicking on Edit, the Excel web access web part, modify the shared web part, and now I'm going to navigate with this ellipsis button to the shared documents library and the file that I publish. So double click on that file, I can go ahead and say OK now, and momentarily I should be able to display the file that I published. In here I can go ahead and click on Exit, Edit Mode, and I can play around with my new web part by entering a new tag name and entering new ranges also of time. So let's say that I want a range going from now to maybe 45 days back. Let's see what comes up. Alright, so plenty of data, 45 days back. Let's see, what about CDT 158? Alright, so we also have some data there for CDT. Now what I want to do is I want to go ahead and edit this page, and I'm going to add an RT time range web part and also a text filter web part in order to submit a time range and a tag name without having to use this parameter fields here within the Excel spreadsheet. So in the left column I'm going to add a web part, and I'm going to look for the RT time range web part, select it, add, and I will modify it. I want to go to Edit, Modify, and what I want to do here, I want to use a vertical layout. I'm going to click OK, and from the Edit menu I'm going to go to Connections in the RT time range, send filter data to the Excel web access data link demo part, and in here the connection dialog window opens, and I want to select Get Filter Values From, configure the connection, and I'm going to use those filter values from the time range. And let's see if this is going to work. And the way I can test it here is by exit the editing mode, and I can go ahead and enter 24 hours and let's see how the data changes. So I see here that the data is changing. It went back to 24 hours. Let's go ahead and do 45 days, apply that, and see how I can not only now change the time range, but I can also use my scroll back and forward features. I can revert to the default settings. I can scroll back with the arrows, and that's all very well. Now let's go ahead and configure a text filter web parts so that we can do a similar thing. Let's go to site actions, edit page. We can do a similar thing with the tag name. In here now I'm going to add another web part. This is going to be a text filter web part, and if I scroll down, let me see if I can find this text filter. Here we go. Click add, and what I want to do now, I want to modify this web part. I want to enter a filter name, which I'm going to call tag name, and I'm going to enter a default value by going to the advanced options. And in here, let me see, I think I missed it. There is advanced filter options, default value, sinusoid, and in the option that I opened earlier, appearance, I want to change the title of this, and I'm going to name it tag name also. I'm going to click OK, and now I'm going to configure the connections by sending filter values to the Excel Web Access web part. Again, I want to configure this and use those values for the tag name. Click on finish, and now if I exit the edit mode, I can see now how the fields for my tag name and time range have disappeared, because now these web parts are connected, and I can go ahead and enter CDT 158 here and update the information. I can go ahead and revert back to the default time range, which is now to 2 hours ago, and I can see how all of the features in here are working. Very, very useful web part. The client is not required to have Excel to be able to access this web part and enjoy of many of the features, the display options of Excel, without having to have Excel actually installed in your local machine. All you need to have is Excel services running in SharePoint, and you just need to create the Excel file and publish it to that shared document library. I hope you enjoy the lab, and until next time.